This is a microphone stand. I'm sure most of you are staring at your computer monitor right now, just trying to figure out why in the world they spent so much time explaining something that you probably already knew. Well, watch this. Welcome everyone to the first episode of Production Tricks, the show where you're going to learn a bunch of different tips and tricks and everything to get your video or productions out on the road quickly and easily. Using your products as multitaskers, as I like to call them, can save you a lot of time and money. You just saw me use a microphone stand for something completely different than it was designed for. You don't have to buy a separate stand. It's going to cost you another $100 probably. The stand back here, which I just set up, those two stands alone cost me $40 total. You guys, I have a third one, $60 total, and I can set up the full-length green screen on it. Get some clamps that are about a dollar or two a piece at Home Depot or whatnot, and you got yourself a great light stand. It saves money due to you not having to buy so many pieces of gear that you might not use all at one time. So why not use that one product that's not being used currently offset and put it to use somewhere else on set? It also saves you time. If you have to load in like 8 different products and only use one or two of those products at one time, why load in all those? Microphone stands can be used for the shotguns overhead, and when they're not being used for that, you can put a backdrop on them. So it saves you time and money. It's a great start, and I highly suggest getting into this. I started setting up stands like this for green screen and backdrop work about 3 months ago. I had gotten a few more microphone stands just to use around the studio actually, and I was filming outside one day and decided I wanted to try some green screen work with one of the cars. And so I couldn't really think of any ideas on how to set up the green screen behind the car, get that space and follow the lights, and keep it in place nice and steady. Couldn't have anyone hold it, it wouldn't be still enough, and there was a little bit of wind at the time, so I had to get a stand type setup and really fasten it down. I ended up coming to the idea of using the microphone stands, and I set them up in the T formation like I did behind me, but with all three that I have, and it turned out great, guys. Awesome idea that I came up with here, and as you can see, I've been using it every now and then for my videos now in the studio, and it's great, especially when you don't have anything else to fasten your backdrop to. So what should you look for when buying a microphone stand to use as a backdrop stand? First, let's go over the two different types. They have many different sizes, everything from a low profile, which is probably a foot or two off the ground, used for miking guitar amps and bass drums for an acoustic set. They also have these large boom arm ones, which have a weighted bass and can really get the boom up high enough for overheads on drum kits and such. These two types will not really work for our case. What we want is a standard height microphone stand. Now, when talking about the standard height ones, they'll come in two different types. They'll have the fixed boom and the adjustable boom stands. What we're working with here, and what I highly suggest you get, is the adjustable boom microphone stands. You're probably thinking, what the hell is the boom on a microphone stand? So let's take a look closer at a microphone stand. Let's start out with the boom itself. All the way down at one side, we have the counterweight. And all the way at the other side of the boom, we have the threaded little bit where you can screw on your microphone clip. Towards the center, we have the set screw, and you can adjust that set screw. You loosen it up, and you can slide the boom in or out. The reason you want this for a backdrop is so you can center that boom arm. We'll talk about that in a little bit. We have the angle adjustment with a large set screw. That's on every microphone stand I have ever seen. And towards the middle of the stand, we have the collar, so you can adjust the overall height. What else? Let's go over fixed boom now. Fixed boom microphone stand does not have that little set screw for the boom arm, meaning you cannot slide it in or out. I highly suggest not going for this model because you cannot center that boom arm to evenly distribute the load. With the adjustable boom, you want to center that boom arm. It'll even everything out. It'll give you a one single point so you're not going to be falling over when you put something heavy on it. Overall, great feature to have. So now you know the difference between the two microphone boom and microphone stand types. Let's move on to material types and how to set this up. I'm using a heavy material for my backdrop. This is a muslin material. This is a chroma key in green, also known as green screen. And what I use to attach this to the microphone stands are these single spring-loaded clips. $1, $2, $3 at HomeDepot.com, depending on what you get. Really inexpensive, they hold extremely well. You just clamp it onto the microphone stand, and as you can see, it's working great. Next, you want to go and find these stands on the internet, of course. And what can I say? These microphone stands are amazing. How about $20 US currency, you guys? I have not seen microphone stands this great anywhere else for the same price, not even for double that price, for that matter. I've seen these microphone stands, the same features on this type of microphone stand, going for $50+. Why spend that when you can get a $20 microphone stand, which also comes with a microphone, which isn't so great. Comes with a microphone cable and XLR, which is great also with the microphone stand. Comes with a microphone bag, and it comes with a microphone clip. And of course, the stand itself. $20, can't beat it, you guys. Check it out. Musiciansfriend.com. Item number is on the lower third, and I'll put it in the credits. So, with that said, I'm not going to ramble on too much more, because you know how I love to do that with these videos, as I'm sure you know. But, so I'm going to close up this video. I've had a great time doing these videos, you guys, but I have to take a break for a while. I have a large school video production, and I'm going to be working on that for the next 4 weeks, doing shooting and editing. It's going to be an abstract-type project. If I can, I will put it on YouTube when I'm done. I'm trying to figure out how to export from Avid Express from the school. I also have the skate clip that I'm trying to export in the next few days. I'll get that on YouTube if I can. But anyway, I just really enjoy making these videos, and everyone on YouTube is watching. Thanks for watching. You guys are the reason I do this video. I love helping everyone out. I had an inrush of subscriptions about a week and a half ago, and last week as well. And it must have had like 10 people subscribe all at once. So keep those subscriptions coming at me, guys, and I'll accept them. So I'm Dave from Sonic Group Studios. Stay tuned for my future videos, and thanks for watching.